Hello guys, a very good morning to all of you. I hope that you all are doing very well in your preparations for your exams. So in today's video, I have a lot of interesting news. So let's start today's video. And before that, I would like you guys to subscribe to this channel and hit this bell notification to get to remain in touch with us to know about the instant updates about our channel. Also, you can join this Telegram group where you can get your queries resolved and enjoy the free quizzes. The link is in the description box below. So let's start the video with the first question. So the first question is, with which country has IIT Kanpur and Archaeological Survey of India signed an MOU for restoration and protection of historical monuments? Quite easy the purpose is. So let's discuss the answer directly. So recently IIT Kanpur and Archaeological Survey of India has signed an MOU with Italy. So this MOU will help India as well as Italy to conduct research for restoration and protection of their historical monuments. Now here one point is of major importance, and that point is that Mukesh Sharma, so he is a professor at IIT Kanpur and he will be the coordinator of the activities that are going on under the MOU. So his name is quite important because he is the only coordinator of this of the activities that will be held under this MOU. So do remember his name. Now for your homework, I will tell you three questions. So the three questions are currency, capital and the PM of Italy. So these are the three questions that you will be telling me in the comment section below. Now let's discuss our second question. So which state has ranked first in implementing the Pradhan Mantri Street Vendors Atmanirbhar Nidhi, that is short named as Swanidhi scheme? So this Swanidhi scheme was launched for street vendors in order to give them working capital loans, that we all know. So this scheme has been in the news for quite some time now. So I expect my students to know the details of the scheme. And if you don't know, then do watch the session in which this scheme was discussed in detail. So the session is PIB 247. So you can watch the scheme there in the PIB 247 session. And now for the time being, let's discuss the answer of this question. So the state which has topped is Uttar Pradesh. So Uttar Pradesh has stopped in implementing this scheme, and in three categories, that is applications, sanctions and disbursement. So these are the three criteria on which the states were judged in terms of applications, sanctions and disbursement under this scheme. So Uttar Pradesh has stopped in all these three categories, and the state which comes next to Uttar Pradesh is Madhya Pradesh and then Telangana. So do remember the top three states, that will do wonders for you. You don't have to remember the other states, just remember the top three states, that will be suffice your preparation. So that's all for the state wise. Now the city wise list was also released. So in terms of city, again top seven cities, the cities under top 10, out of the top 10 cities, seven cities were from Uttar Pradesh. So the cities which have performed very well in implementing the Swanidhi scheme, the top three cities are Varanasi, Aligarh and Lucknow. So these are the three cities which have performed really well in terms of implementing Swanidhi, and out of the total top 10 cities, seven cities are from Uttar Pradesh only. So this is how, from here you can yourself understand how good Uttar Pradesh has performed in terms of implementing this Swanidhi scheme, which is for street vendors. And under this scheme, working capital loan of rupees 10,000 is provided to the street vendors. So that's all for this question. Let's move ahead with the next question. Where is the DST IIEST solar PV hub located? Now first of all, let's discuss the full form of this. So DST is Department of Science and Technology under the Ministry of Science and Technology. IIEST is Indian Institute of Engineering, Science and Technology. So, Department of Science and Technology, Indian Institute of Engineering, Science and Technology have together launched this solar PV hub. Now, where is it located? It is located at the premises of this Indian Institute of Engineering, Science and Technology, which is in Shibpur, West Bengal. So, the answer is option A, West Bengal. Do remember this thing. Now, guys, an interesting fact about this solar PV hub is that the sanction for establishing this hub was made as early as in 2018, and right now this hub has been inaugurated at this institute. Now, what will this hub do? This hub will conduct the research and development activities in order to popularize the solar energy, solar PV systems in entire eastern as well as northeast areas. So, this will be the hub for East India as well as Northeast India. So, these are the two regions that this hub is going to target. So, therefore, this is very important for us to remember. And do remember this thing, that this is located in Shibpur, West Bengal. So, that's all for this question. Let's move ahead with the next question. 6. BRICS Parliamentary Forum was held under the chairmanship of which country? Quite a simple question. So, those who know that which country is the chair of BRICS in 2020 would also know the answer of this question. So, guys, do you know that which country is the chair of BRICS in 2020? The answer is Russia. Option A, Russia. So, Russia has conducted this forum. Now, my question for you is that you have to tell me that who is the chair of BRICS in 2021. This is your task for the day. I have mentioned this fact in the Spotlight magazine for quite a number of times. So, I hope that majority of you who are reading Spotlight, who are following Morning Tales, would know the answer of this question. So, do tell me in the comment section below that which country is the chair of BRICS in 2021. Next question, which bank has partnered with IIFL, which is an NBFC, to expand its business activities in the underserved and unserved regions of the country? Quite a good initiative from a bank side in order to increase the financial inclusion in country. So, which bank is it? So, the answer is CSB Bank. Now, the CSB Bank was earlier known as Catholic Syrian Bank. So, this bank was located in Kerala and it is a private sector bank. And this bank has partnered with this NBFC in order to expand its business in underserved and unserved regions of the country. Now, you would be amazed to know that this bank has a specialty in gold loans. Therefore, this bank is going to expand its loan business in unserved and underserved regions. So, it will be a boost for the rural India, for the unserved people who don't get credit so easily. That the CSB Bank has partnered with IIFL and these two organizations are going to expand their services in the underserved or unserved regions of the country. So, that's the last note of this question, and let's move on to the next question. But before that, I would like to hear from you that who is the MD and CEO of this CSB Bank? Quite an important question it is. Do tell me in the comment section below. Next question. So, what is the theme of Vigilance Awareness Week 2020? First of all, you should know that which organization observes this. It is an indigenous week observed by India and not by any particular organization in the world, like we have UN, World, WHO. So, this week is not observed by any kind of international organization. This is an indigenous week observed by India. What is the purpose? The purpose is to celebrate the integrity of India. Now, you would also know this thing that This is observed from 24 to 31st October, and on 31st October it is the birthday of the Iron Man of India, that is Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. So he had that dream of integrating India. So in order to honor that marvelous personality of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, this Vigilance Week is observed in India, and the purpose is to celebrate the integrity of India as well as to uphold that integrity of India. Now, what is the theme of 2020 week? So the theme is Vigilant India, Prosperous India. In Hindi, it is translated as Satark India, Samruddh, Satark Bharat, Samruddh Bharat. Now, guys, apart from this, you should also know that CBI, that is Central Bureau of Investigation, has also conducted a national conference on vigilance and anti-corruption. So this national conference has also the same theme, that is Satark Bharat and Samruddh Bharat. So this is the theme of the national conference organized by CBI. This is again an important fact. Do keep this in your mind. Okay. So this question ends here. Let's move on to the next question. Which company is India's top rank in Forbes World's Best Employers 2020? So can you make a guess here? Out of these five options, that is ONGC, SAIL, NTPC, Bay, HPCL, which country is it? Oh, sorry, which company is it? It is option C, NTPC. So NTPC is ranked at 261. So 261st is the global rank of NTPC, and among the Indian companies, it has been ranked as the top in the Forbes World Best Employer 2020 list. Now, which company has topped this list globally? It is Samsung. Now guys, can you tell me where is the headquarters of Samsung Electronics? We all use the mobiles of Samsung so often that we usually forget that Samsung is not an Indian company. So this is for you, this is your task, that you will tell me where is it located. Next question, and this is also the last question. Who is the author of Night of the Restless Spirits, Stories from 1984 book? Quite a simple question, but an important one as well. So the answer of this question is Sarabjit Singh. So option E is the right answer. And here this session ends. I hope that you have really liked this session. And if you have, and if you have learned anything from this session, then do give a thumbs up to us and also watch this session regularly. Thank you so much.